Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophynut and welcome back to our Let's Replay series in Bioshock 2, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the lore and the story of this game. Just pick up on a few details that you might have missed otherwise. So, we're here at another corpse where we're gonna put down our own little sister. And as you can see, I created two kind of death corridors where they're not gonna pass through that easily. So, let's not wait any longer and start gathering Adam. Because she's really excited, apparently. I think I hear one over here. Okay. One died behind us. I think if I... There we go, that's another one. Those are almost out. There we go, let's keep ourselves a bit cornered so they don't take us down that easily. Ooh, she blew up. Okay, that kind of backfired. Is nobody gonna come from the other side? There we have one, and there we have the other one. Okay, I think that's... yeah. Ta-da! Pick up. Don't harvest. Pick up. There we go. Let's take the two trap rivets that are left, because those trap rivets actually do a lot of damage. Four of them take out a splicer, and there's a big daddy walking around here. Are you dead? You look dead. Thank you. Firestorm. Ryan Industries presents a warm welcome for your enemies with Firestorm. Set your foes on fire when they strike. So you emit a burst of fire when struck by melee attacks, damaging all around you. Again, the same with static discharge. I don't really like that because you can accidentally aggro a big daddy. And if you're not prepared for that, that's not really handy now, is it? Let's see if we can find anything else here. Seems to be another splicer down there. Might as well take a picture. And then go with Electrobolt and shock the water she's in.
It's dancing, Daddy, dancing!
Yes indeed, she's dancing, dancing all around. Look at that, trap rivets, paupers drop. And let's listen to that.
Do you remember what you told me, Bill? A marketplace of ideas, that was you. If I submit to the debates with Lan, we defang her. I've done so. And have you been to Pauper's Drop, Bill? Listen.
When you're down and out.
Between each song, these Oblomovs hand out her manifesto. Her face adorns every wall. Saint Lan. You made her, McDonough, and now you will convince the council to sponsor her silence.
So there we go. You might remember McDonough, Bill McDonough, from the previous game, the engineer that turned out to be a big player in the creation of Rapture and the governing of it later on. And he was actually apparently... Okay.
There's one of those big goons now. Start your camera rolling on him, and then let him have it.
I am going to, but I need a minute. So McDonough was a very important character in the creation of the city, and Andrew Ryan actually convinced him to take Lamb down because he wants to. Hello, Big Daddy. You wanna get out of my way? Thank you. Let's see if we can take care of that camera first. With this thingy. There we go. And there we go. Okay. So now we can start taking a picture. There we go. That's one shot. And then we should probably go for heavy rivets. That's not the Electrobolt. And in the face, a new ability, Drill Dash. Devastate your foes with this powerful dash attack. And I'm going to show you that in a minute.
Look at you, sport. A regular junior shutterbug. And it appears you've picked up a new trick from that big galoot. Now get back to the Sinclair Deluxe and just bust through that mess blocking your way.
Stop. Damn it. There we go. So that's another splicer taken care of. I am hurting though, so let's see if we can't find anything else that could bring our health back up. I am trying to figure out where we are exactly. We're at the Jazz Theater. Let's see, do we need more supplies? I could use a few remote hack darts, so let's hack it. There we go, so 00 buck and 50 caliber rounds, thank you very much. Maybe one Eve hypo, a few remote, oh, I can only buy one. And then a few of the, oh, okay, that's it apparently, that is it. So now we can perform a dash. I kind of missed the prompt there. I think it's... yeah, like that. Okay. So now we can drill dash if we want to. That takes up a bit of our drill fuel, but it's really, really cool to use. But let's first head in here. And let's see what's inside of the Jazz Theater. Let's whack this thing down. Thank you very much. Because this is where we heard, okay.
Here, father, it's yours. You are evolving fast, but your heart is getting weaker. I can keep you alive, but you must find me.
So this is the same place that Andrew Ryan and Bill McDonough were talking. The same place where Grace Holloway was performing, the Limbo Room. There we go, those two are dancing. And then we're gonna end that abruptly. And there we go. So this is where Grace Holloway performed in back in her day, because you see a lot of posters depicting her as well. But we got another plasmid over here, Hypnotize. So yeah, we've run out of plasmid slots, no biggie, but confuse your foes into attacking each other. So instead of Hypnotize Big Daddy, it has kind of been merged with Enrage and just targets pretty much everything. Calls enemies to become hypnotized and attack anyone nearby. We don't need that just now, but it might come in handy later on. Let's see, more Eve hypos. We can't really check that out. She probably got the hypnotized plasmid out of this machine she broke by using the little sisters. And there we have another little drawing. Let's see, we have the ticket booth. Doesn't seem like there's much here. So let's enter the limbo room itself. Oh yeah, we could use hypnotize on those, we could have used that on those two splicers. That was a perfect opportunity to do so, but let's get on stage. Don't think there's much to see here except a bit of ammo. And of course, music playing. We will be reborn. And what's this? I'm not entirely sure of all the details, of course, but this looks promising. So let's go with the machine gun damage for now, because we have a lot of versatility with that weapon. So there we go. Improved barrel. Yeah, newy toy indeed, little sister. There seems to be all in this room, so let's move forward. And there seems to be more in her dressing room. You should not have come. Yeah, we probably shouldn't have. And there we have Grace's dress. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Is there? Yeah, there's a note there here. Closing the limbo room.
That's it. We have to close down the limbo. Bomb goes off in that fancy place uptown and everybody panics. Pulls their money out of the banks. A whole city tugging on the same dollar bill. So the banks fold, and maybe 1 in 10 got their savings out. Who's gonna come here and mean nightingaling about how broke they are? How am I gonna provide for little Eleanor?
So there we go. They had a bit of an economic crisis in Rapture, as it seems. And that caused everybody to, well, not go out anymore, causing Grace Holloway to shut down the limbo room. And of course with her not knowing how to provide for Eleanor, because she's caring for her at that time. Okay, so that's the limbo room. Nice bit of side information. What was that? Is that just that big daddy just walking around here? It appears it is. So, we still have our little sister and we still have one corpse we need to harvest. I know where that is, but I just want to take a bit of a look around further first. Don't think I need to... Could of course buy the anti-personnel round, so let's hack this thing. There we go. Double buck and trap rivets. We have a lot of money, so I might buy the extra auto-hack dart and then the anti-personnel rounds. We could use those. I don't think we need any more trap rivets. And then let's use those anti-personnel rounds. Although, I'm gonna save those up for when we do another harvest, just in case we might be able to use that. And speaking of which, of course, now that we made a full loop.
For Grace, the paradise of Andrew Ryan was most unkind. She spoke against him in song, and he had her blacklisted. It left her penniless. But in the family, she has found hope, a reason to draw breath. Ask yourself, Delta, do you deserve to take it from her?
There we go. So Grace Holloway was branded a traitor just because she couldn't find a way to provide for Eleanor anymore. Let's see if we can't take a picture of the Tuggish Splicer. Let's take him out. Increased wallet cap. You can carry more cash, which is really, really handy. And there we go. The machine gun bullets doing their job wonderfully after that lovely update. Upgrade, I should say. So, I could set up a bit of a defense, but that's a bit hard with... we have a turret. We have... Ooh, I can actually get that hack dart back. Thank you for that. We have a turret, we have a camera, that should be plenty of defense for now. We have a bit of backup resources here as well. So I'm not gonna immediately set up a lot of trap rivets, maybe a few. There we go. Normal trap rivets, but we're gonna go with the machine gun. Thank you for the rivets. Is there something?
Here it is.
Greenfield cake, thank you very much. So, let's gather Adam, our second harvest of the day. I think I'm gonna go in here. Looks like a pretty defensible position. And the camera and the turret should take care of most of the splices coming in. Oh, they can see me through the... There we go, triggered. They triggered my trap rivets as well. There we go, don't let anybody get close to her. They know where I am without actually laying eyes on me. Let's take a lovely picture. Is that thing firing at me? Ooh, wait. Boom! So that was a drill dash. Kinda loving that actually. And there we go. Where is she? Where did you go? Fuck you. Ooh, I love that drill dash. Never actually used that much on my original playthrough, but that is actually really, really powerful.
Daddy,
so let's pick her up.
Are you taking me home too?
Yes, I'm gonna take you home too. Anything else on that corpse? No, doesn't look like it. And now we need to be careful, cuz we're gonna be having another fight with a big sister just because we gathered up the last of the little sisters. So let's take the backup resources here. There we go. Let's use an Eve Hypo now and fill that up as well. And then let's pick armor piercing rounds, heavy rivets. And yeah, normal buckshot, but let's reload. Oh, Don't even need to reload. So if I now drop her off over there, we're gonna get attacked if I'm not mistaken. So let's make sure that everything is fine. She's leaving. So let's drop her off. Rescue. Take care now, little girl. There we go. 80 extra Adam. And now. There we go. Big sister is coming for you. Get ready for a fight. I don't think I have that much trap rivets left. Maybe put them all on this wall. Don't really need a big setup here. I do need to be careful that I start recording the moment I set eyes on her. Let's get you in the water. Nope, okay. This is gonna be annoying. I think the leadhead splicer died. So let's start researching. There we go, increase max Eves, and big sisters are vulnerable to armor piercing rounds. Well, I have that hit right here. And she's almost dead actually because of the armor piercing rounds. Hi. What is she doing here? There we go. That was weird. She kind of tumbled over the big sister. That was really weird looking. But thank you for that, big sister. 40 Adam extra. And then an Eve hypo and $56. The Adam is a really, really nice touch. But because, of course, big sisters, as you can see, they're female. And because 10 years have passed since Rapture first went into despair, we can actually assume that big sisters were originally little sisters, also indicated by their strength, because the Adam made them nigh invincible. What the hell? There's a shadow running through. Yeah, hello. Yeah, hi. There we go, shocked to death. Always an original way to kill someone. And let's use an Eve hypo and get that Eve hypo back from the big sister. Okay, so that's done with that. We have a lot of Adam to spend. Now I'm thinking if I missed anything. So no, that staircase leads up there. We went on top of there as well. So I think we pretty much went around the place. So let's head back to the center area, the fishbowl diner, and let's see what we can find over there. And, well, we need to clear the rubble in the Sinclair Deluxe. Do I need anything here? Doesn't look like it. Okay, Grace Holloway. The likes of you. Okay, that was not what I wanted to do. That was probably not my best idea. That might have been a better idea. Jesus Christ. Woman, die. Why are you still running? You were shocked. Okay, she doesn't have anything apparently. That was weird. I had that a few times now that I shock a splicer and it just start running for some reason. Downtown. Is there something downtown that I still need? So that's the king. Ooh, that's a brute with a turret. I don't really want to... Well, a bolt. I don't really want to mess with that. So let's enter the hotel. The Sinclair Deluxe. Okay, a splicer that gets special treatment and gets subtitles for some reason. And popcorn. Hello? Oh, that looks like it's gonna, yeah, explode. There's someone behind me. Let's take a runny route. Okay, and is that me chewing on the potato chips? Apparently that is. So they were waiting for me. They set an ambush for me. That was not very nice of them. King Pawn, yes indeed. Let's use telekinesis and take this with me. Just in case I encounter something, I can blast it immediately with this barrel, if I can see through it a bit. Then see a splicer on the left. But we might actually encounter one on the right here. What happens if I... Oh, I can actually do this. Swap weapons like that.
Just rev up that drill of yours and slam right through that pile of junk blocking your way.
Okay then, here we go. Boosh!
Shh, shut up. Here he comes.
Okay. I can see you, you know. Telekinesis. And increased damage versus Turkish splicers. So... And goodbye.
Now Gracie was on the top floor. Get on up there and persuade her to give you that override key.
So this looks a lot like the Mercury Suites from the previous game, which is actually intentional, I think. But I do want to take a look around. I think I drilled someone to death here. Does she have anything of interest? Apparently not that much. Let's go with the anti-personnel rounds. You don't have health kits, which might hurt a bit. There's a hack dart over here. But I might be in a bit of a pickle health-wise. Let's get up the stairs. I hear a camera, but I think it's on the top floor, if I'm not mistaken. Let's take a careful look around. So the butterflies are also a very nice touch, because of course the butterfly is the symbol of Sophia Lam. And you have been seeing that all over the place, even on the masks of the splicers every once in a while. Yeah, Big Daddy, you're apparently angry. I could try and take him out just for the research, but I don't think that's really handy. But the first aid kit, that's very handy. Eve Hypo, well, why not, eh? Let's reload that and get the Eve Hypo to get to top up. And then a gift from Lam.
I know it's wrong to feel so fine right now, but I can't seem to quit this grin. Dr. Lam came to tell me that Ryan's finally gonna lock her up. It's gonna gut the believers, and I should feel the same. But Sophia remembered that I was barren, and she asked me to take care of her baby while she's gone. Baby Eleanor Lam, gorgeous, clever little girl. I have a child now, and it's gonna put the whole world all right.
So that's a really, really interesting one. So it was kind of implied throughout a few of the previous audio diaries, but Andrew Ryan eventually locked Sophia Lam in prison, in the Rapture prison. And that's why Lam told Eleanor to stay with Grace Holloway for a while. Grace Holloway couldn't get any children of her own, so she was more than happy to take care of Eleanor. That's also the reason why she's so mad at us, because she thinks that we actually had something to do with, defiling her little girl, if I want to put it like that. Let's see, there's another room across here, so let's... Hello? There we go. A bit of research further on. I heard something else. I think I heard some ruckus. Ooh. Oh yeah, I remember this hallway. Let's wait with that. Let's smash this up. Thank you very much. So that's a beginning. This is a very dark hallway with a few dead splicers. Not that they're really dead. Can I actually get on the top floor from here? Apparently I can't, so let's check out the other side here really quickly. If there's anything, doesn't seem like it. So, let's head through the dark hallway. And see what's in there. And my flashlight turns on immediately again. And the jazz as well. Can we open this actually? Doesn't look like it. So let's keep the camera rolling. Hello? You dead? Can't seem to open any of the rooms. That is a corpse. Okay, I could check it out. Okay, thank you very much. You're also a corpse. There's another one over there. Oh, she looks creepy. There we go. Let's shock her. And then maybe a shotgun to the face. Ow. And she's crying. She's still crying, although she's dead, but... Didn't expect the second one. That was... Was she actually quoting Shakespeare there? Because I think she was holding a skull. Let's auto-hack this thingy. There we go. 40 anti-personnel rounds will be used. A lot, I think, in this place. Because it's filled with splices. Because this is Grace Holloway's, well, mansion. You missed there, lady. Let's set her aflame for a bit of variation and kill her outright. There we go. That guy might be dead as well. Don't seem to be able to focus on that guy, so he might be dead as well. But let's take a look. Hello, corpse. And lots of dark corridors.
The baby snatcher's headed up into the hotel family. He wants me so he can get to Eleanor. Tin Daddy feels no guilt. Tin Daddy feels no pain. But we are the family and we can teach him how.
Oh, I do want to take the coffee, but not the moonbeam absinthe. So, Sander Cohen's favorite drink. Are you dead? You seem dead. Anybody else who wants to jump up? Because this suddenly turned into a horror game. Oh, you're not dead, are you? Ooh. He shotgunned himself to death for some reason. So a lot of suicides in this part of Rapture. And as I said before, Sophia... Ooh, I saw you. Sophia Lam made it a point to that her followers could sacrifice their life for her, for the cause. Where the hell is he? Okay then. Where the hell did he go? There's another one over there. There we go. And there we go. A quiet tonic scrounger. One research track complete. So that means I think we completed research on the thuggish splicer. So splicing scrounger is like having a sixth sense. You'll spot things you'd otherwise miss and discover things you'd otherwise leave behind. With scrounger, you'll swear you have X-ray vision. So when searching containers or corpses, you can research again to get different loot. We had that already in the previous game. Okay, and she exploded, kind of. That was a nice pause. Let's take the drill fuel. And yeah, so that's the end of the thuggish splices, I think. We don't need to research them any further. We're gonna have to do that with the leadhead splices though still. So more stuff to get. I am gonna take a little break though. So we have a nice little shrine over there with a camera. And when we get back, we'll, well, I think we'll be able to confront Grace Holloway. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!